So today I want to address a very fundamental difference between Eastern philosophical systems and modern quantum mechanics regarding the observer, because this is one of the areas that causes a lot of confusion. So in Eastern philosophy, the observer is seen as a non-local formless entity, contrasting with Western views that often regard the observer as a classical biological system. And this perspective suggests that the body and mind interactions are mere appearances within a broader entangled reality. So the body-mind are, and its interactions are appearances within a broader entangled reality. To me, this explains the Eastern perspective explains the simultaneity of function in all biological systems. The simultaneity of function in biological systems is now being looked at a very fundamental microscopic level as well. And it is referred to as polycomputing. So polycomputing in biological systems refers to the ability of the same biological substrate to simultaneously perform multiple computational tasks. This concept is significant in understanding how biological systems manage complex functions efficiently. Here are some examples of polycomputing in biological systems. One, mitochondria. In photoreceptors, mitochondria act as microlenses, demonstrating their ability to perform optical functions alongside their primary role in energy production. Two, proteins. Proteins can exist in multiple conformations, allowing them to participate in various biochemical processes simultaneously. Three, gene regulatory networks. These networks can store multiple memories and behaviors, enabling them to regulate physiology in real time while also facilitating learning processes. Four, chemical networks. These networks can perform tasks similar to neural networks, showcasing their ability to process information in a distributed manner. Five, DNA. DNA can have overlapping or dual coding genes, meaning it can encode more than one protein from the same sequences, thus performing multiple functions at once. Ion channels. Some ion channels also function as transcription factors, integrating electrical and genetic regulatory roles. Cytoskeleton. The cytoskeleton can perform computations through biochemical, bioelectrical, and even quantum mechanical dynamics, highlighting its multifunctional capabilities. So these examples illustrate how biological systems use polycomputing to achieve a high level of efficiency and adaptability, allowing them to perform complex tasks that are essential to survival and adaptation. This multifunctionality is a key feature of all biological systems, enabling them to respond to environmental changes and internal demands effectively. Now, if you do some research and try to figure out if this polycomputing is quantum, you'll get mixed results from search engines. So polycomputing is not inherently quantum, but it involves simultaneous processing of multiple computations through quantum superposition and entanglement, on and on. Bottom line is polycomputation takes place at all levels: microscopic, ultra microscopic, quantum mechanical, and whole body systems. I mentioned before, how does the human body think thoughts, play a piano, kill germs, remove toxins, make a baby all at the same time while tracking the movement of stars and planets as its own biological rhythms? So all this is actually pointing to omnipresence, omniscience, and omnipotence. When I say these things, regular mainstream biologists and physicists roll up their eyes. Okay, there's no evidence for this. But I'm asking you, is polycomputation, which is at every level, from ultra-microscopic, quantum mechanical, to whole body systems, first of all, it's obviously quantum, in my opinion, even though, most quantum biologists will say you don't see quantum effects at body temperature, but it's happening, okay? But even deeper, it is consciousness, self-regulating, self-evolving, self-evolutionary, as I said, self-evolving, and having infinite organizing power. This is divine. And that's where mainstream scientists, that's why mainstream scientists balk at the idea that fundamental reality is an expression of omniscience, omnipresence, and omnipotence. But I want to know your thoughts. And once again, Digital Dharma is out, and you can ask me questions by going to digitaldeepak.ai. Thank you, and I hope you're having a wonderful day, and I hope I'm not wasting your time. God bless.